Welcome to Prabodhana 2020, a webinar series on Charaka Samhita Uttarartha. Last time it was because of technical issues, we postponed the session to the today morning. Today we are having eminent speaker, Dr. Shashireka HK ma'am with us. Madam is a renowned author of the Charaka Samhita and she even authored so many books, which I will eventually know in the, which I will let you know in the introduction part. And today, madam is going to deliver 1 to 6 chapters of Kalpastana, and today and tomorrow afternoon at 1 p.m. to 3 p.m. from 1 p.m. to 3 p.m. ma'am is going to deliver from 7 to 12 chapters of Kalpastana. I welcome you, ma'am, for this session, and I welcome all the students for this session. Dr. Shashireka HK ma'am, born in Hassan, Karnataka, she completed graduation in 2006 and post-graduation in Ayurveda Samhita 2010 from Rajiv Gandhi University of Health Sciences, Bengaluru, Karnataka, and PhD in Ayurveda Samhita from Tilak Maharashtra Vidyapeetha, Pune, Maharashtra. Ma'am completed MA Sanskrit from Karnataka State Open University, Mysore, and MSc Psychology from Madurai Kamaraja University, Tamil Nadu, and MSc Yoga from Periyar University, Salem, Tamil Nadu. She published many articles in various peer-reviewed international journals. Currently, she is working as Associate Professor in the Department of Samhita Siddhanta at Sri Dharmasthala Manjunadeshwara College of Ayurveda and Hospital, Hassan, Karnataka. She is acclaimed teacher for graduate and postgraduate scholars. The other works of one, textbook of Swasthavritta, research methodology and medical statistics for undergraduates, research methodology and medical statistics for postgraduate students of Ayurveda, Charaka Samhita Sanskrit test with English translation, volume 1, Sutrasthana, volume 2, Nidanasthana, Vimanasthana, Sharirasthana and Indriyasthana, volume 3, Chikisasthana, chapters 1 to 15, volume 5, Kalpa and Siddhisthana. With this brief introduction, I welcome you, ma'am, for this session. And now I request Dr. Shashireka HK, ma'am, to start the session.
Thank you, madam. Good morning, everyone. First, I want to thank Sri Jagadguru Gavisiddheshwara Ayurveda College, Koppal, for organizing Prabodhana 2020 and giving me an opportunity to present a topic in this webinar series on Charaka Samhita. And I want to thank Dr. B.S. Saudi sir, principal sir, and moderator Dr. Hema madam for giving this opportunity. In this series, continuously you are into the subject, that is Charaka Samhita, first to two, Chikitsa Sthana, first to 30, and all those has been completed. Now, in continuation to that, Charaka Samhita Kalpasthana, I'm going to present today. My voice is clear? Is it clear? Is I'm audible?
Ma'am, you are audible.
Yeah, slides also visible, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Whenever a kalpa word comes to our mind, it is always, it indicates the preparation, formulations. Okay. It always indicates the preparations. Okay. So in Sutrasthana part itself, already we studied that certain drugs which are indicated, which are most useful for Vamana and Virechana procedure. That is in Charaka Sutrasthana, 4th chapter, Shat Virechana Shatashati Adhyaya, it is mentioned that Shat Virechana Shatani Iti Yaduktam Tadiha Sangrahena Udahritya Vistarena Kalpopanishadi Vyakyasamaha. There is an opinion that Kalpasthana and Siddhisthana were added by Dridabala. If it is so, then why Charaka Samhita has mentioned that Kalpopanishadi word in Sutrasthana itself? That indicates this is the contribution of Charaka itself. But it may be missed or it may be added by the dridabala. But the intention to write this kalpasthana was there at the beginning of the samhita itself. So it is mentioned that there are 600 yoga, vamana virechana yoga are mentioned in a brief manner at the context of sutrasthana itself. And there only it is mentioned that sangrahena udahritya. Sangrahena udahritya. Very compiled manner as an example here it is mentioned, but further vistare kalpopanishadi vyakyasyamaha, that is in a detailed manner kalpopanishadi upanishad. Madam, some voice disturbance is there, I think. In kalpasthana, especially Upanishad word always indicates the knowledge. Here Kalpa Upanishad, that indicates related to Kalpa, everything, the details of that has been given in the Kalpasthana. So it is termed as Kalpa Upanishad. And in this context itself, all the 600 yoga and their numbers has been mentioned. Regarding Kalpasthana, few Acharya didn't mention at all. Few Acharya focused Kalpasthana as an unique sthana. In among them, Samakalina to Charaka, that is Agnivesha Tantra, that is Bela Samhita, Harita, and the Kashyapa Samhita, we will find Kalpasthana. That is once again related to the content. There is a lot of difference, lot of differences also there in these Samhita. And coming to Ashtanga Sangraha and Ashtanga Hridaya Sushruta Samhita, here Ashtanga Sangraha and Ashtanga Hridaya, they have combined Kalpa Siddhisthana and they termed as Kalpa Siddhisthana itself. And Sushruta Samhita, Kalpasthana is mentioned. And and related to the content of the Kalpasthana, related to the content of the Kalpasthana, here in Bela Samhita, if you go through with that, here Madanufala, Ikshvaku, Damargava, Kutaja, Aragvada, Ballataka, Sudha, Danti Kalpa, Shankini, Shyama, Trivrat, and Amalakadi Yoga has been given. In Harita Samhita, Haritaki Kalpa, Trifala Kalpa, Haritaki Veda, Rasona Kalpa, Gugulu has been mentioned. Next in Kalpasthana of Kashyapa Samhita, mention Rakshognangana, Graha Chikitsa, Lashuna Kalpa, Katu Taila, Matra, and Shat Kalpa Yoga, Bhojana Vidhi. Like it is not focused to Vamana Virechana as such, it is given in the Charaka Samhita. If we'll go through with the Ashtanga Sangraha and Ashtanga Hridaya, along with Vamana Virechana, even Basti is explained under this context. And related to that, Vyapar, along with the Chikitsa is mentioned. Then related to the Panchavida Mahakashaya and Trivida Snehapaka are mentioned. Then in Sushruta Samhita, if we'll go through with that, Visha Chikitsa has been explained. Like Visha Chikitsa, Jangama Visha, Stavara Visha, Visha Dravya, those all has been given. So this shows Charaka Kalpasthana have its own uniqueness, because only related to the Vamana, related to the Virechana has been explained. Further, I'll explain how it is still more, it is important to study. Coming to the definition of Kalpasthana related to Charaka Samhita as such, Vamana Virechananam Kalpaha Tishtanti Asmin Iti Kalpasthanam. That means Vamana Virechananam, that is the drug which are related to the preparations are related to the Vamana and Virechana, where it is explained, that itself is termed as Kalpasthana. The section where we are getting the Vamana Virechana Kalpa, we are termed as, that is termed as Kalpasthana. So why this is Kalpasthana? The name Kalpasthana is mentioned. Always we will get two words, Kalpa and Anukalpa. Okay, Kalpa always it explain prime preparation, important preparations. Anukalpa always explains the secondary preparations. Here, Vamana Dravya as a whole, it is explained in the Charaka Sutra Sthana. Charaka Sutra Sthana, second chapter itself. Madanam, Madukam, Nimbam, Jimutam, Kritavedanam, Pippali, Kutaja, Ikshvaku, Yela, Damargava. These all are some few drugs which are related to the Vamana. But if we'll go through with the Kalpasthana, some drugs are missing in this list. Okay, these all the drugs are not mentioned in the Kalpasthana. You may get the doubt, why in Sutrasthana some other drugs are there? Why in Kalpasthana some other drugs are there? What is the intention to give this type of difference? Here, Vamana Dravya always we need to understand under two heading, that is Vamana Karaka Dravya and Vamanopaga Dravya. Here Vamana Karaka Dravya, that which causes the Vamana, that which causes, which does, which helps for the Vamana. Here Vamanopaka, which facilitates, it is like a supportive, it is like a secondary, which are like a supportive to the main procedure. So here example are given like, if for Vamana Karaka Dravya, Madana Phala, and Jimutaka, Kritavedana, what drugs are given in the Kalpasthana, they are mainly Vamana Karaka Dravya. And Vamanopaka Dravya, like Eshti Madhu, Kshira, Vacha, these all considered as a Vamanopaka Dravya, which helps for the Vamana. Next, coming to Charaka Kalpasthana and its importance, very specificity, how to understand before starting to the Kalpasthana, we need to understand what are the uniqueness of the Kalpasthana. Okay, how we have to understand that one. Here mainly Vamana and Virechana Dravyas are mentioned, which are helpful for the Vamana Virechana therapies. Then main drugs which are causing the Vamana, that has been given. And the drugs which causes the Sukhopabhoga, which improves the healthy state. Here Sukhopabhoga, once again, for the procedure also and in the later stage also, it should causes the healthy state and comfortableness to the body. Such type of dravya we need to select. Those all are explained in the Kalpasthana. And here Bedartha here, classification has been given, like 133 yoga for the Madana Phala, 39 yoga for the Jimutaka, like the classification has been given on the base of their importance and the preparation. Next, wherever it is necessary, in detailed manner, the description has been given. Wherever it is similar procedure is there it is clearly mentioned, it is similar to the Madana Phala preparation, it is similar to the Ikshvaku, like that, the specificity also has been given. Nowhere it is skipped, okay, the complete preparation method with the dosage has been given. Next is, here some people are like, they are having much selectivity. Like few people are comfortable with Swarasa or Kashaya or like that. So in them, we can select which type of preparation is suitable to that person. Here, we need to fulfill our purpose. Even though along with that, we have to consider Purusham Purusham Viksha. Like we have to consider individual according to his desire. Then only we can select a particular medicine. Those all can be achieved through Kalpasthana. Here, Nana Vida Desha Kala Sambhava Swada Rasa Virya Vipaka Prabhava Grahanat. That is, here we have to consider individual prakriti, vaya, bala, agni, bhakti, satmya, and rogavastha. According to that, we have to alter the medicines, alter the preparations. Then only we can achieve the expected result. Then here, deha word is mentioned. Deha here is stula krushadibihi. Stula krushadibihi, like we can't generalize the medicine. Like Madana Phala, for all the person, we can give the Vamana with that. We can't generalize in that way. We have to select a medicine according to Stula person, according to Krusha person, then we can select. Those all can be achieved through understanding this kalpasthana. Next is bhakti. Here bhakti, it refers the ichcha, desire. Okay, like individual having, there is a specificity in their desire. So in that case, according to their desire, already in 26th chapter of Sutrasthana, you had studied, patya always, it refers to the interest of the person, always interest of the body, how body is responding. According to that, we have to decide the patya. Here also, while deciding the medicine, we have to think of the interest of the person. Then only we have to select the medicine. Then avastha here, avastha which indicates roga avastha. It is not like in all the cases, same type of medicine cannot be given. So we have to understand which is the avastha of the disease. According to that, you have to continue the treatment and you have to select the medicine. And here, etc., that word has been mentioned, Adi Shabda, that once again refers Sattva, Ahara, Satmya, Dashavida Pariksha. What and all Dashavida Parikshas are there that you have to consider. Then once again, here Sarvatra Kaleva Praptyaham. This is one more very much important. Like it is not like all the qualities are there, but the availability is not there. It is not at all like that. Such type of Dravya is not going to helpful. We have to see the availability, and according to the according to that only we have to select the drug. Qualities are there, everything is there, but availability is not there, means there is no much use. So you have to consider that also. According to that, you can select. Here sukartha, sukha bhoga, that's the one of the word you come across in the above slide. Here sukartha means in both the way you have to understand. That is tatkala sukha, uttarakalina sukha. That is tatkala sukha, that is immediately what and all the procedure we are conducting, like during the vamana, what pradana karma we are doing, in that whatever drugs you are administering, it should be very much comfortable. Okay, comfortably we should eliminate out the vitiated dosha. In that way the drug should be like madana phala, it is anapaitvata, that is the word it's given, which means which causes the very less complications. So that is tatkala sukha. Then uttarakalina sukha is like in later period. Okay, in later period means even after the procedure of vamana, you have to assess what is the effect, that is post effect, what we will tell, no, that is the effect. Uttarakalina sukha, that also we have to consider. Okay, by considering these two, we have to select the drug. And in Kalpasthana, we are getting 600 yoga. Is it, we have to limit to the 600 yoga? Not at all. It is asankheya. According to your yukti, according to your intelligent power, you can decide n number of preparation, n number of whatever drugs are given, you can prepare in different way, which is suitable in that way you can prepare. Here, whatever it is given, it is a clue. Okay. It is a clue for the selection of the drug. Next is, we have to consider the avastha. Okay. Here in previous slide, it's given, no, avastha, that is this roga avastha. Here for that, one of the context which I had taken as a reference here, that is Charaka Siddhi Sthana, 11th chapter, Phalamatra Siddhi chapter. There was a discussion between the Acharya and the Atreya Punarvasu. They were discussing that certain drugs are very superior and in particular diseases. Like that they were discussing, like Jimutaka is Shreshta, Katutumbi is Shreshta, Arkutaja is Shreshta, Damargava is Shreshta. Like that they were telling their opinion. In that context itself, Atreya Punarvasu concludes the session as Jimutaka is Shreshta in Kushtavikara, in skin disease. Katutumbi is Shreshta in Madhumeha or Prameha Roga or Mutravasruta Vikara. In that Kutaja is best in the Rudroga. Damargava is good in the Panduroga. Kritavedana is good in the Udara Roga. And Madanaphala Sarvagada Virothi. That is, in all the disease condition, you can select the Madanaphala. Next is here one more head taken, that is Avastha. According to Avastha, how we can select the Chikitsa? This reference I had taken from the Trimarmiya Chikitsa chapter. There under the heading of Rudroga, I had taken this reference. Here, if Rudroga or the pain persist in during the empty stomach, in that condition, we have to select this Sneha Virechana. If pain aggravates during the digestion, then we have to go with the Virechana by using the fruits. Okay. If pain persists throughout the day, that is even before food, during digestion, after digestion, that is throughout the day, if pain persisting, then we have to administer the Virechana by using the Mula. Here, you have to consider, like, disease is same. Okay, Rudroga is the same, and the therapy what you had selected, that's also same, Virechana. But the way which you need to select is Sneha Virechana. Virechana by using Phala, Virechana by using Mula. See, only one disease is there, but you are selecting different types of drugs, different types of useful part. Okay. For this, you can go through with the 8th chapter of Nidanasthana. There it is clearly mentioned, one disease, many drugs, like that concept, what it is there, no? That holds good here. So while seeing the, while selecting the drug, we have to consider the Avastha as such. So as a concluding shloka here, Tani tu Dravyani Desha Kala Guna Bhajana Sampat Virya Baladhanat Karya Kriya Samartya Tamani. That is here how the drugs will get the action, like the, how it is going to act on the body, how it is going to differ in its action. That is on the base of Desha, on the base of Kala, on the base of Bhajana, that is the vessel, how we are storing. Then Sampat, that is abundance, or how the potency of the drug is there in that. According to these all, the drugs are going to act on the body. Next, one more topic is given in the first chapter of Kalpasthana, that is types of Desha. Under the heading of Janapadodvamsa, once already it is mentioned, the Desha, Dushita Desha, how it will be in that way. Here, Desha is mentioned because Desha is mentioned with respect to collection of drug, which place we supposed to select for the collection of drug. Okay, like some drugs are very good in the Jangala Dravya, some drugs are good in the Anupadesha, some are from the Sadharana Desha. It's not like every time we cannot be able to select from particular Desha itself, but it is a choice. Okay, like Prashastha Bhumi, what we will tell, no? Like the drugs are having more potency if we are collecting in particular land. Like here, as already you are knowing, just it is a repetition of that. Here, Jangala Desha is it's like a open space. There is no much forest area or thick tree will not be there. And the plant which are having thorns, okay, and small leaves. Okay, such type of plants will be observed in that area, like Kadira, Asana, such type of plants. And if you want to select such type of drug, then you're supposed to select from the Jangala Desha itself. Such type of plants will not have much potency if you are collecting from the Anupadesha. This is the uniqueness, like it is in relation with the collection of the drug. And plenty of sand will be there, gravels will be there, like such type of area, especially while selecting the drug, you have to consider. And peoples in relation with the Jangala Desha, always they are dominant of Vata Dosha. So that also we have to consider while selecting the medicine. Next, coming to Anupadesha, this is completely filled with the thick plant, forest trees, like very huge trees will be there. And the plants like Narikela, Kadali, such type of plants you will get in that area. and the drugs which are related to such type of area. Okay, like Tuna Panchamula and all, if you are collecting from such area, that is having best quality. Like whichever thick plants, like Panchavalkala, that we can select from such area. Like if I have to select the area, and we can collect the drugs. And Sadharana Desha, it is in between two. Next is Prashastha Bhumi or Dravya Sangraha Yogya Desha. That is which type of area is better to select the drug. The drugs which are grown in the Sadharana Desha or Jangala Desha is considered as the Shrestha. Okay, Anupa Desha is not considered here. Okay, Sadharana and Jangala Desha is considered as Shrestha. And certain time periods has been given for the collection of particular things. Like flowers and fruits need to be collected during the seasonal. Like it is seasonal actually. Okay, such type of dravya we have to collect in that. Sara, we have to collect in the Sharadutu, like particular time has been given. In the same way, particular desha also given. So we have to consider Sadharana Desha and Jangala Desha is considered as best area to collect the drug. Here, some seasons has been given, like Shaka and Palasha need to be collected in the Varsha and the Vasanta Rutu. Moola should be collected in Grishma and Shishira Rutu. Twak should be collected in the Twak Kanda, and Kshira should be collected in the Sharad Rutu, and Sara should be collected in Hemanta Rutu, and Pushpa Phala should be collected according to the season. Next, Doshanusara Anupana. Those who are appearing for the exam, for them this is important one. According to Dosha, particular Anupana is mentioned. For Vata Dosha, Sura, Saviraka, Tushodaka, Maireya, Medaka, Danyamla, Falamla, Dadhyamla are beneficial as a Anupana. Whatever drugs you are giving, as along with that, these all Anupana should be used, especially in the Vata Dosha. If Pitta Dosha is there, Mrudvika, Amalaka, Madhu, Madhuka, Parushaka, Fanita and Shira. This is best in Pitta Dosha condition. Here you have to consider it is not generalized thing. If you want to give Vamana or Virechana, if you are planning for Vamana or Virechana in Vata Dosha person, then along with Vamana Dravya, you can select any of these Anupana. That is the understanding. If you want to give Virechana in Pitta Dosha person, then you have to give, you have to select the Virechana Dravya as such, but along with that, you have to consider which type of Anupana is beneficial according to that dosha. Next is Kapha Dosha. In that, Madhu or Mutra, here Mutra is Gomutra, or Kashaya, which are prepared by Kaphahara Dravya. Usually Asanadigana Dravya can be selected. Okay, so such type of Dravya can be selected in case of Kapha Dosha. Next, now I'm entering into the Vamana as such, main core part of the presentation, that is Vamana and Virechana Dravya. Here Vamana, Vam, always it indicates the emits off or coming out. Okay, so Vamana is like which anything which is coming out. Okay, so here synonyms are Mardana, Chardi, Chardaniya, Vamatu, Vanti, Vamihi, Ullekana, Udgirana and Prachardika. I had mentioned these synonyms because in Charaka Chikitsa Sthana or in any of the Chikitsa, there is a disease and Nidana Panchaka are mentioned. Then further the treatment are mentioned. And under that heading, Shodhana Chikitsa, Shamana Chikitsa. In Shodhana, once again, Vamana should be given, Virechana should be given, like that it is given. The details of that has not been given. And very specific terms are mentioned under particular heading. Like, I'll tell the example. Like, in case of Ama, their word used as Ullekana. Okay. There they didn't mention the term Vamana. There it is mentioned the term Ullekana. So, Ullekana is... It is not you have to do the utplesha of the dosha, then you have to give the vamana dravya. It is not like that. Ullekana is already the dosha in the utklishtavastha. It is in collected manner. Just your work is you have to take out that. And in that context, it is very clearly mentioned, just ushna jala along with the salt. It is sufficient. There it is not mentioned. You have to give shastrokta vamana for snehana than that. No, such mentioning is not there. So you have to consider such type of wordings. Okay. Wherever mardana is used, once again, you have to understand that something is collected, that you first you have to make it into churn, then it should be take it off. Okay. Like next is chardana, that is vomiting. Chardaniya, that is which causing the vomiting. Vamatu, vamatu or vamana. Vamatu always which causing the nausea. Okay. Then vamatu, that word, it explains the nausea. Then vanti, that is here act of vomiting. Then ullekana, that is already which is collected, utklishta avastha dosha, that should be eliminated out. Then udgirana, that is once again ejecting whatever the collected material is there, that should be ejected out. Then prachardana, like whatever collected is there, that should be vomited out. Here, these are all different synonyms of vamana. While reading, you have to understand. You have to understand like which term is mentioned. According to that, you have to alter the treatment. Next is virechana. Here, virechana, that indicates rechana, like which is eliminated, the collected dosha in the adho marga. Okay. And different terms like virechana, praskandana, virekaha, vedana, anulomana, sramsana. These all different terminologies you come across in many contexts. Like some context, vedana line of treatment need to be given, anulomana line of treatment, sramsana line of treatment. Of course, these all virechana only, but in the action itself, there is a minute change. Okay. Wherever anulomana is mentioned, you can't able to give tikshna dravya. Or samsana is mentioned, generalized line of treatment cannot be given. Okay. Like it is not like virechana means it is not trivrat. Vamana is not equal to the drug like madanasala. There are choices are given by the acharya. We need to select which is suitable to that condition and what drug need to be selected in that condition. Here in Sharangdhara it is mentioned anuloma means which eliminates the pakvamala. Okay. And stramsana, that is shlishtamala, what it is there, that should be eliminated out. That is stramsana. Vedana is which does the bheda, which splits the mala, then it eliminates out. That is vedana. Rechana is whatever pakva or apakva, everything which is eliminated out. See here terminologies, whatever it is given, according to that, you have to select the drug. Next here, vamana is, which is urdhva mukhena dosha nirharana. Urdhva mukhena dosha nirharana. That is the dosha eliminated out through mukhamarga. Okay. Urdhva bhaga or mukhamarga. Adho gudena dosha nirharanam. Adho gudena dosha nirharanam. That is virechana. Like through adho bhaga or gudha marga, if you are eliminating out the dosha, that is called as virechana. In many contexts, you will come across with the term virechana. Okay. So that virechana once again indicates even vamana as well as virechana. Rechana means it is eliminating out. Okay, maybe urdhva bhaga or adho bhaga. That is the thing why virechana, which includes both vamana and the virechana. Next, qualities of vamana dravya and virechana dravya. Here, both Vamana and Virechana Dravya are having similar nature, similar properties, like Ushna quality are there in both, Trikshna, it is there in both Dravya, Sukshma quality, Vyavaya, Vikasya quality, these all are similar. But only the difference is Agni Mahabhuta and Vayu Mahabhuta will be found in the Vamana Dravya, and Virechana, in Virechana, Prithvi and the Ap Mahabhuta will be there. And if you'll go through with the qualities of Agni and Vayu Mahabhuta, especially Agni, which is having the Prabhava of upward movement, and Prithvi and Ap Mahabhuta, which is having the Prabhava of downward movement. Okay. So it is always, it differs because of this Mahabhuta difference. Next, coming to the Karmukata. This is very important for those who are appearing for exam. Vamana Virechana Karmukata. Here, Ushna Virya, which does the Dosha Vilayana. As you know, the Dosha, which moves from Koshta to Shaka, Shaka to Koshta, in that context it is given. Ushna, Tikshna, Sukshma, these all are the quality where the dosha move from one place to other place. That is from Shaka to the Koshta. Here also same applies. That is dosha vilayana done by this Ushna guna. Okay. Kapha vriddhi is there, as you know, kapha is the quality, solidification is the quality of kapha. So the vilayana of the kapha is necessary, as solid form cannot be taken out through vamana. So before to that, we have to do the dosha vilayana, and we have to bring that dosha from koshta to, sorry, shaka to the koshta. For that, here Ushna Virya is beneficial. Like dosha vilayana is done by Ushna Guna. Next is Tikshna Guna. What it does, Tikshna Guna? Vichandeti, vichinna. Vichinna is which separates. Okay, which separates. Like under the heading of Kriyakala, you had studied the term Sanchaya, Prakopa. The dosha Sanchaya takes place, dosha accumulation, dosha liquefaction takes place. What is the understanding behind that? How to understand that one? Here, dosha liquefaction, that is vichinnata. What that compactness is there, in that the liquefaction, the separation need to be brought out. So that action will be done by Tikshna Guna. Next is Sukshma Guna. Here, Sukshma is which is minute, okay? Because of that Sukshma Guna, which could able to enter into the minute channel. Whatever the dosha is there, which enters into the minute, the drugs which enter into the minute channels and which bring to the koshta, so that easily it can brought out to the, as a dosha should be eliminated out. Next is Vyavahi Guna and Vikasi Guna. Vyavahi Guna, which pervades to entire body, which spreads throughout the body very fast. Okay. Vikasi Guna, which brings the looseness. That means the joint and all, which is very, very much compacted. Okay. One of the property of kapha is bandha. Okay. Sthirata. Like bandha, that is compactness. One to one, what that contact is there, that binding, what it is there, that Shithilata is needed bring out that dosha, vitiated dosha, and that will be done by this Vikasi Guna. So whatever Shithila Bhava is there, that is provided by the Vikasi Guna. And one more very important one is among Panchavata, Udanavata having role in this condition. As you know, whatever is having movement in our body, it is because of Vata. Especially Udana Vata is facilitating the dosha to come out from the upper direction. And here Udana Pranunna, Pranunna, which facilitates for the movement of the dosha in the upper direction. Even Pranavayu also having the role, but mainly Udanavayu. Next, effect of Mahabhuta, how it is having a different action, because all the five qualities are similar. Then how Mahabhuta are differing the action of the drug. here in Vamana Dravya, as the previous slide mentioned, like Agni and Vayu Mahabhuta is predominant. And in Virechana, Prithvi and the Up Mahabhuta is Pradhana. It's not like other Mahabhutas are not there. As a Prabhava itself, Agni, which moves in the upward direction, and Prithvi and Jala, which always sediments, always settles, and it moves towards the downward direction. So here in previous slide, whatever Ushna, Tikshna, Sukshma, Vivayi, Vikasi, these all what properties are there of the drug, these all what it does, the dosha, vitiated dosha, which does the vilayana and liquefied, and it brought back to the koshta. And it should be, it now what to be done? Now it should be eliminated out in the upward direction or in the downward direction. Here, if Agni and Vayu Mahabhuta is there, the Dravya will move towards the upward direction. If Prithvi and Jala Mahabhuta is there, then Dosha will move towards the downward direction. That's the thing. Sometimes, if you are administering for the Vamana Dravya, for the purpose of Vamana, sometime it will happen Virechana. And even in Vamana Vyapata also, it is clearly mentioned, you can go through with the Virechana. And even one more reference is given, like Vamana is Shreshta Chikitsa for the Kapha and Madhyama Chikitsa for the Pitta. And Virechana, Shreshta Chikitsa for Pitta and Madhyama Chikitsa for Kapha. Like the properties of the drugs are similar. Only the thing is the upward, which route the doshas are emanating out. Okay. That is done by the involved Mahabhuta in the drug. So while selecting the drug also, it is not like only in that drug Ushna Virya is there, we can select that one. No, it is not like that. We have to consider the Mahabhuta, and by knowing the properties itself, then we can select the drug for the Vamana or the Virechana. Next, coming to still more core part of the Kalpasthana, that is in this sthana, total 15 drugs are mentioned, that is Madanaphala, Jimutaka, Ikshvaku, Damargava, Kutaja, Kritavedana as a Vamana Dravya. And for Virechana, Shama Trivrit, that is Aruna Trivrit, Shama Trivrit, together is mentioned, but Shama Trivrit, the chapter name, usually used for the Virechana purpose. Next is Chaturangula, Tilvaka, Mahavriksha, Saptala, Shankini, Danti, and Dravanti. These all are the drug mentioned in the Kalpasthana. Next, Kalpasthana, first chapter name is Madana Kalpa Adhyaya. This is the first chapter. Here, you can identify these drugs. In first pick, it is complete fruit, okay, dried fruit. And the second one is in middle, what fruit is given, that is the Madanaphala Pippali. Now, it is the collection of Madanaphala. We have to, like you had studied the Jangala Desha, Anupadesha, and Sadharana Desha. There it is mentioned, Jangala Desha and Sadharana Desha is the best for the collection of drug. Here in third pick, if you will observe, there is a thorns, okay? Leaves are very less, okay? You can observe that pick. Here the Jangala Desha should be selected for the collection of, and the fruit should not be bitten by the any insects. That is, complete fruit should be there. Okay. It should not be half or bitten by any insects or birds. Such type of fruit should not be selected. And it should be greenish color, yellowish greenish color. Green means it is in a ripening form, and slight changing of that color to yellowish color and dark brownish color. That is of ripened fruit. Okay, after that, here Pakva Phala should be selected. Gomaya Lipta. Gomayena Lipta, here you have to collect that fruit, and in that dry grass should be selected, and over that you have to cover, and that should be kept in the Gomaya. Then after few days, after 15 days or 7 days, according to the fruit, how much it is dried, according to that, you have to take out, okay? And that should be processed along with the Grita and Madhu, okay? Only that inside part should be selected. And it, here in fifth pick, that is Madanaphala Pippali, and that should be kept in the Nava Kalasha Sthapana, that is in the new vessel that should be stored. Okay, here Jangala Desha, there you have to collect the Madanaphala. That should be of greenish yellow color, dried one. That should be selected, and it should not be bitten by any insects. It should not be eaten by any birds or like that. Complete fruit should be selected, and that should be covered with the dry grass. Then after that should be kept in the Gomaya. Here Gomaya, because that increases the temperature, like husk, that is the word is used, that increases the temperature so that for drying it will help. Then after that inside part should be selected, processed with Grita, Dadi and Madhu, and inner part should be selected, that is Madanaphala Pippali, and that is stored in the new vessel. Next, coming to Vamanamidhi, as all the procedure here also, Purva Karma, Pradhana Karma and Paschat Karma is there. This is very important for long essay. Here some Madanaphala Sangraha Vidhi, Samrakshana Vidhi, that will be the question, and along with the Vamana Vidhi. Here, as Purva Karma, you have to give Snehana and Svedana. And after getting the Samyak Snehana Lakshana, you have to give 2 to 3 days gap. Okay, 2 to 3 days gap. Once again, you have to consider individual. According to that, how many days gap is required, that you have to decide, 2 days or 3 days. And here, in that days, you have to give Kapha Vriddhikara Ahara. Okay, Kapha Vriddhikara Ahara. Because how much you will do the dosha utlesha, that much Samyak Vamana Lakshana you will get. So you have to does the dosha utleshana. Okay, you have to increase the dosha. Okay, here some of the examples are given, like how we can increase the dosha, like gramya, anupa, mamsarasa, kshira, dadi, masha, taila, and some of the shakadravya. By that we can increase the dosha. Okay, kapha utlesha need to be done. Next is here, on the day of Vamana, here once again, here also Purva Karma and Pradhana Karma will be there. Here, Purva Karma, we have to prepare whatever the necessary things are there, that we have to prepare and keep it aside. In the second slide itself, I had said, like Vamanopaka and Vamana Karaka, both the dravyas need to be prepared in this for the future. Here, as a Vamana Dravya, you can select any of the dravya, like Madanaphala, Jimata, according to condition, whatever you can select. And as a Vamanopaga, something should facilitate the Vamana. For that, Eshti Madhu Fanta, or Kshira, or Ushnajala, like that, anything you can select. Okay, so those all you can prepare and keep it aside. And Yavagu should be prepared by using the jaggery. You know, that also need to be prepared. This all as a Purva Karma on the day of Vamana, you have to do. Okay. Then Mangala Charana should be done. This is one of the reference where you will come across with the mantra. Okay. There is a mentioning of the mantra, Om Brahma. Like that one shloka is there. Like before starting any of the procedure, we have to pray the God. Here, praying the God just to increase the confidence in the treatment, okay, by the patient. That is one thing. And whatever the procedure you are conducting, everything should complete in a proper way. For that also, you are praying the God. So that Mangala Charana should be done. After that, what that Yavagu you had prepared, that should be given to ye, to the patient. After that main what that Vamana Dravya you had selected, that should be given. After that, you have to administer the Vamana Karaka Dravya, like whatever Kshira is there, or Eshti Madhu Fanta, or such type of any of the Dravya you can select. After that, main Vamana Dravya should be performed. Vamana is the main Pradhana Karma in this. Next is, once again, at we have to see the vamana samyak lakshana, like at the end what is coming out, that should be observed. Like the in a projectile manner the vamana should come out, that vomitus should come out, and you have to count the vega, how much the administration has to be is done, that much should be the vomitus. Maybe a slight difference, but you have to measure how much it came out. Okay, that is the vamana procedure as such for the pradhana karma. And as such for paschat karma, dhumapana, panipada prakshalana, and later to that samsarjana krama need to be followed. This same procedure even in sutrasthana upakalpaniya adhyaya, in a brief manner it is given. Okay, while reading this one you can refer that also, and for samsarjana krama once again you can refer the siddhisthana first chapter. Next is vamana samyak lakshana, like pittanta should be there. First kapha will come out, the whatever the drugs you had administered, that will come out, then kapha will come out, then after that followed with that pitta will be. So in some context vataanta also mentioned, we need to consider vataanta as a pittanta itself, because vata we can't able to see, so pittanta we need to consider. Next antiki, the again pitta should be anta. Okay, that what yellowish color, what that contains, if you are observing, that itself is considered as the antiki. Okay, maniki, that is the quantity, how much the vomitus is, like uttama matra is 2 prastuta and madhyama matra is 1.5 prastuta and avara matra is 1 prastuta. And vegiki, here that vega, that projectile, what that urge is there, that you have to count. Pravara, that is 8 vega, madhyama 6 vega, and avara 4 vega. As langiki, that is linga, that is lakshana, that is rud pashva murdi indriya shuddhi, that is there is a clarity in hridaya pradesha, pashva pradesha, and indriya, and lightness in the body. These are the lakshana you will find as the vamana samyak lakshana. Next is here, while preparing the yavagu, madhu and saindava, even as a anupana, while telling the doshanusara anupana, I had mentioned the madhu. So what is the importance of that madhu and saindava here in the context of vamana is, though especially madhu and saindava does the vilayana as well as chedana of the kapha. As previously I said, no, like vilayana is very necessary while bringing the vitiated dosha from the koshta. Okay, for that here vilayana as well as chedana need to is done by the saindava lavana as well as madhu. So while giving the vamana, you have to mix this one, mix madhu and saindava, then you can administer. Next here, you may get the doubt that here you are preparing all these and you are heating ushna jala, you had mentioned yavagu need to be prepared, like that it is given. No, even the madhu administration in any form, in case of vamana, it is not causing any of the adverse effect to the body, because without undergoing the digestion the vamana is taking place. Just it is going inside, whatever the vitiated dosha is there, that is coming out as a vomitus. Here there is no process of digestion, but in virechana that process of digestion is taking place, after that the virechana is taking place. That is the main difference between the vamana and virechana. So in virechana case we are not at all using such type of dravya. Here we have to consider what procedure we are doing, and in that what and all the stages are taking place in the body, that we have to consider. Here madhu is not giving any adverse effect to the body as such. Here synonyms of madana phala, madanaha karahataha rataha pinditaka phalam, these are the synonyms of madana phala, and it is beneficial in sarva rogahara, that's the term previously I had mentioned. In many contexts, many disease condition, this is beneficial. Madana phala is beneficial. This is usually asked question for 2 marks. the synonyms of madana phala, madanaha, karahata, rata, pinditaka, phala, and shasana. These all are the synonyms of madana phala. Next, coming to madana yoga, total 133 yoga are mentioned. Okay, kashaya 9 yoga, matra yoga 8, kshira, dadi, santanika, navanita, grita 5 yoga, panita 1 yoga, churna 1 yoga, greya 1, varti kriya 6 yoga, leha 20, modaka 20, utkarika 20, shashkuli apupa 16 yoga, shadava 10 yoga. So total 133 yoga of madana phala. Okay, here madana phala you are selected and you wish to administer for the vamana purpose. Here you can select any of the procedure, any of the preparation according to the disease condition, according to the suitability of the person. Bhakti, that is the word I had mentioned, no? So according to the interest of the person, according to the Ichcha, and according to the demand of the disease, you can select any of the preparation. Now coming to Kashaya. Okay, all of you are knowing Kashaya, how to prepare. Like one part of the drug and equal part of the water should be selected, and it should be reduced to 1/4 or 1/6 or 1/4. Like how the drug is there, according to that you have to add the water, double quantity or 4 times of the water, how much it is required, that should be added here. Here the preparation goes like this. Vamanopaka Dravya, Shadvirechana Shatashati Adhyaya, there it is mentioned Vamanopaka Dravya as that 10 drug, Kovidara, Karbudara, Nipa, Vidula, Bimbi, you may be remembering that one. So those all drugs, here 9 drugs are given. So those drugs along with the madana phala and how much it is required, that much water should be added, and keep it aside for whole night for the soaking purpose. Here all the drugs, it is somewhat dry. Okay, so those all drugs should be keep it as it is for the for soaking purpose, and filter it for 21 times. Then add 3 parts of madana phala pippali to that. Okay, and made it into vati form, or as such even the kashaya also can be given. Here the pills what you had prepared, that is for the vamana, to cause the vamana, and that kashaya what you had prepared, that is to bring the vitiated dosha. Here vamanopaga, as a vamanopaga you can use this kashaya, and as a main dravya you can use that vati. Okay, and the indications are like praseka, granti, jwara, udara and the aruchi. Next is about the kshira yoga. Here under kshira yoga there are 3 preparations are given: kshira, dadi and santanika. Here kshira is, that is kshira paka, how you will prepare, no? 1:8:32. Here the kshira along with the madana phala, you have to process that kshira. Need to be reduction, does the reduction as such you are preparing the kashaya, that should be taken as a kshira here. Madana phala pippali kshira, and madana phala pippali dadi, you have to make it into cool you have to allow that as it is, keep it aside and made as a dadi as such. Okay, that is dadi. And madana phala santanika, that is whatever the creamy part is there, without removing that one, if takra is there, that is santanika. Like without removing that one, just we are collecting and we are using for the vamana purpose. Next is madana phala matra yoga. Here that is phala pippali, 3 parts should be taken, and 2 parts of remaining drugs here: kovidara, karbudara, nipa, vidula, bimbi, shana pushpi, sada pushpi, pratyak pushpi. Okay, these all drugs should be taken and made it into pill form at the size of haritaki, arbibitaki, aramalaki. Okay, that is the size, for the size indication that's given. So madana phala matra yoga, that is 18 number. Next, madana phala Navanita and Grita Yoga. Here Navanita one yoga and Grita is second one. So Navanita should be like Dadi you had prepared previously, in the same way Dadi should be prepared. And then Navanita, the extraction, like the butter should be taken out from that. And that is one yoga. And the same Navanita prepared into Grita. Okay, that is one more yoga. So Navanita and Grita yoga. Next, Madanaphala Churna. As you know, Madanaphala, it is somewhat hard. Okay, so we have to make it into powder form. Here, Atapa Shushka Phala Pippali Churna, like the fruits should be like the process how previously it is given, same way you have to. Then the Madana Phala Pippali, what it is there, that should be made it into dry. Then it should be made it into powder form. Here, directly you can give, or else it should be sprinkled over the. It should be sprinkled over the flowers, and you have to give that flower for smelling purpose. Here, the churna yoga you can give in that way, or else the directly the churna can be given for the administration for Vamanartha. Next is Madanaphala Swarasa or Phanita yoga. Here, the juice of Madanaphala should be Madanaphala Pippali. Wherever Madanaphala is mentioned, you have to consider Madanaphala Pippali only. The seed should be taken, okay? And here that should be processed as like the Phanita, okay? When it is become the solidified or semi-solid form, as like Leha form, that should be given for the patient for Vamanartha. Next here, Madanaphala Churna, how you had studied previously, in the same way you have to prepare the churna, and that should be sprinkled over the flower and keep it as it is for whole night. Next day, that flower should be given for the smelling purpose. Here, Greya Yoga, especially used in those who are very much Sukumara, very delicate nature is there, and even Mrudu Koshta person is there. By the smelling itself, the person will start vomiting. So in such condition, we can go with the Greya Yoga. Without internal administration also, the person will does the Vamana. Next is Madanaphala Varti. Varti, as you are knowing, it is one of the preparation. Usually Varti, it indicates the Gudavarti. Okay, here Madanaphala Varti should be prepared. Okay, and it is nothing but it is a synonym for the vati as such. The vati, it is in the round form, and the varti you are preparing in as like it is shown in the picture, that is it should be prepared in that form. And here vati, for that varti phala, that is Madana phala, Jimudaka, Ikshvaku, Damargava, Kutaja, these all together you can prepare the varti, or else separately you can prepare and need to be administered along with the kashaya. Here kashaya, wherever it is mentioned, that is in first slide what I shown, that is like all the vamanopaka dravya should be used for the preparation, like kovidara, karbudara, nipa, vidula, bimbi, what drugs are there you are preparing the kashaya, such type of kashaya can be used, or as Madanaphala kashaya itself can be used in this condition. Here Madanaphala Leha Yoga, here 20 different drugs are given. In left side, I had given one photo. That is the procedure of Avaleha preparation. Like a general method, what the preparation is there, same thing should be followed here. While preparing the Madanaphala along with the Aragvada, Arukshaka, Aswadukantaka, Pata, Patala, Shringeshtaka, Murva, Saptaparna, Naktamala, Pichumarda, Patola, like this 20 drugs, different drugs. With that, you have to prepare the Leha. And here, I didn't mention the procedure as such here. I have shown the photo. First, you have to prepare the Kashaya, then Jaggery is the media. And with that, you have to prepare by following the same method of preparation, common method of preparation. Here, Tantu Mantra, that shown in that photo, till that appearance, you have to prepare that one and that should be stored and it given for the Vamanartha. And next is Utkarika and Modaka Yoga. Utkarika 20 Yoga and Modaka Yoga here. Here, Modaka is nothing but pills only, but it is in somewhat bigger size. Okay. And Utkarika, it is a Mamsa Yoga. Usually we will term for Mamsa Yoga, like the liquid material will be there along with that solid, solid preparation is dipped in that liquid. So that is Utkarika, and that should be prepared by using these all drugs. Okay. And this is for Utkarika and Modaka Yoga. And Madanaphala Shashkuli and Apupa Yoga. Here I had shown that Apupa and Shashkuli Yoga. The Madanaphala should be used along with the Kashaya prepared as previously given. And you have to prepare as like the like powder and liquid both need to be mixed and made it into Shashkuli or Pupa. Pupa is nothing but as like the puri, regular how we are using. In the same way here, more liquid should be, more oil should be used, and over the tawa, we have to fry that one. So that is the pupa, okay? And that can be prepared and given for the Vamana purpose. And here other yoga like Sumukha, Surasa, Kuteraka, like along with these drugs also, the yoga can be prepared. Next, Madanaphala Shadavadi Yoga. Here, it is not a preparation as such. Okay. Here, Shadava, Raga, Leha, Modaka, Utkarika, Tarpana, Panaka, Mamsarasa, Yusha, Mudga. These all are some of the preparation. Madanaphala should be used along with these. Okay. Madanaphala along with Shadava, along with Raga, along with Leha. Like that, there are 15 yoga. Next, I'm continuing with the second chapter of Kalpasthana, that is Jimutaka Kalpa. Jimutaka Kalpa. Here, useful part is fruit as well as flower. Here, in left side, I had mentioned the fruits. Here, this is the plant, how it is, and these are the flowers, how it appears. This flower, and this is the fruit, how it is going to appear. Next is your Jimutaka Kalpa. Jimutaka Yoga, there are total 39 yogas are there. The synonyms of Jimutaka are Garagari, Veni, Deva Tadaka. Garagari, Veni and Deva Tadaka. Total 39 yogas are there. Kshira Yoga, 6. Suramanda Yoga, 1. Guduchadi Yoga, 12. Aragvadadi Yoga, 7. Jimutaka Matra Ashta Yoga, that is 8 in number. Jivakadi Yoga, 4. Grita, 4. I am repeating. Kshira Yoga, 6. Suramanda, 1. Guduchadi Yoga, 12. Aragvadadi Yoga, 7. Jimutaka Yoga, that is 8. Jivakadi Yoga, 4. Grita, 1. So total 39. How to collect this Jimutaka for treatment purpose and what are the effect? Okay, here yata guna yukta, yata deshaja, yata vidhi. Here these three terms are mentioned. That indicates previously before starting to the Vamana Virechana and Madanaphala Kalpa, I had explained some of the important points that need to be applied throughout the Kalpasthana. Here, yata gunam yuktam, what and all guna are mentioned, okay, that is prashasta guna are mentioned, that you need to be collected. Yata deshaja, where it is available in that land, you have to select, preferably sadharana or jangala desha. So beginning what I had explained, that you supposed to apply throughout the Kalpasthana. And yata vidhi, and here phala and pushpa are the useful part, and we need to collect these phala and pushpa as seasonal, okay? In which season the fruiting season is there, flowering season is there, during that season only we have to collect. And coming to the therapeutic effect, how it is going to give the effect over the body, and in which condition we can select the drug. It is tridoshagnaha. Tridoshagnaha. That is wherever Sannipatija Vikara is there, Tridoshija is there, Tridosha Vikaras are there, then you can select the Jimutaka. And as a disease, Shwasa, Jwara, Hikka. Okay. Similar to such type of Vikara. Okay. You can select the Jimutaka. Here, Jimutaka is useful in Tridosha, Tridoshija Vyadi. And as a disease, Jwara, Shwasa, Hikka condition, we can use the Jimutaka for Vamanartha. Here, first yoga is Kshat Kshira. Okay, there are six Kshira yoga. Okay, first one is Kshira should be boiled along with the flour. Second one is Nivrita Phala along with Kshira. Okay, that should be processed. First one is flour along with the Kshira. Second one is Phala along with the Kshira, you have to process. Lomasha Phala, whatever the fruit, you can observe the loma over that is the hairy structure over the fruit. You can observe that one. Okay. Lomasha Phala. Okay. That is the understanding. Here Lomasha Phala. Lomasha Phala boiled with the milk. That is, once again, Kshira need to be processed. Along with the Lomasha Phala. Then Alomavastha. Alomavastha, usually the matured fruit will be like the hairy structure will not be much. Such type of fruits should be processed with the Kshira as well as Dadi. Okay. Then that is Kshira, then Dadi. Okay. So Dadi Sara, that is named as Dadi Sara. So four preparation over. That is, first one is flour along with the Kshira. Second one is fruit along with the Kshira. Third one is Lomasha Phala along with the Kshira. Then fourth one is Alomasha Phala along with the Kshira and the Dadi. Next is Harita Pandu Phala. Harita Pandu Phala. Pandu Phala, that is in a not completely ripened form. In that form, what the fruit will be there, no? That should be processed with the Kshira. Okay. Then last one is Jirna Sushushka Phala. That is, dried fruit should be used for the preparation. So here six Kshira preparation. First one is flour with the Kshira. Second one is fruit along with the Kshira. Third one is hairy fruit along with the Kshira. Fourth one is without the hairy structure over the fruit, processing with the Kshira and the Dadi. That is fourth. Fifth one is not completely ripened. Okay. That is Harita and Pandu Phala along with the Kshira and the Dadi. That is fifth one. And sixth one is dried fruit should be used for the preparation. So total six Kshira Yoga. Next one is Madhira Manda. Okay. Madhira Manda Prayoga. Here you have to prepare, make it into fermented, this Jimutaka. Pakva Jimutaka Phala should be soaked in the Suramanda and keep it aside for the fermentation. Okay. And this is useful in Kafacharochaka, Kasa, Panduroga and the Ikshma. Next is Jimutaka Kashaya Yoga. There are 12 in number. Okay. Jimutaka Phala should be boiled with all these drugs. There are 12 drugs are mentioned. So 12 Kashaya Yoga. Along with Guduchi, one yoga. Along with Madhuka, one more. Like this. There are total 12 drugs are mentioned. So total 12 Kashaya Yoga. Guduchi, Madhuka, Kovidara, Karbudara, Nipa, Vidula, Bimbi, Shanapushpi, Sadapushpi, Pratyapushpi, Nimba and Kutaja. So total here 12 Jimutaka Kashaya Yoga. Next is Aragvadadi Yoga. Here Aragvadadi Yoga, that along with these Kashaya Yoga, you have to administer the Jimutaka Phala. Aragvada, Vrikshaka, Swadukantaka, Pata, Patali, Shrungeshtaka and Murva. Next is Varti Yoga. Here the detailed preparation and the processing and all is not mentioned. Just that first shloka it is given, no, Yata Vidihi. Yata Vidihi is how it is mentioned for Madana Phala. In most of the condition, the same thing need to be followed. Okay, same preparation method need to be followed. Okay, so here Ashto Matra Yoga, it is similar to the Madana Phala Matra Ashta Yoga. Same type should be processed here also. And the dose here is Kola Matraha. One Kola Pramana Varti should be processed. Next is Jivakadi 4 yoga, like Jimutaka Churna should be selected, and that should be processed along with these rasa, like Jivaka, Rushabaka, Ikshu and Shatavari. These rasa, the here rasa word, you have to consider it as a extract. If dry drugs are there, then you have to take it as a kashaya itself. Then the indications are Pitta Shleshma Jwara and Vata Pitta Jwara. Okay. Pitta Shleshma Jwara, that is in common indications also given. If Jwara is there, you can go with the Jimutaka Kalpa, not with the Madanaphala Kalpa as such. Jimutaka should be used. Next one is Grita Yoga. Like common method, how it is given in the same way. Here Jimutaka Kshira should be processed, and with that Grita is extracted, and it is along with the Kashaya of Madanaphala should be administered for the Vamanartha. Next, I'm continuing with the third chapter of Kalpasthana, that is Ikshvaku Kalpa. Ikshvaku Kalpa. You can see in this photo, there are two varieties of fruits you can observe. Okay, there is a controversy. This one, both we can consider. There is a for Ikshvaku. And the plant, it is similar. Like you can see the structure of leaf as well as the fruit. And here, only difference with the fruits, there is a difference. One is somewhat bulged and one is elongated. Both is considered as a Ikshvaku itself. And you can observe the plant as such. Here, the useful part of the plant is phala and pushpa. Okay, fruit as well as the pushpa. Main useful part I had mentioned, that is fruit and the flower. Next, Ikshvaku synonyms are lamba, katuka labu, tumbi, pindafala and falini. Lamba, katuka labu, tumbi, pindafala and falini. Here total number of yoga are 45 in number. Total number of yoga are 45 in number. Paya Yoga, that is Kshira Yoga, 8 in number. Suramanda, 1 in number. Takra, 2. Greya Yoga, 1. Palala Yoga, 1 in number. Taila Yoga, 1 in number. Grita Yoga, 1 in number. Vardhamana Ikshvaku Yoga, 6 in number. Kashaya Yoga, 9 in number. Vatti Yoga, 8 in number. Leha Yoga, 5 in number. Saktu 1, Mansarasa 1. Okay, so total 45 preparations given for Ikshvaku. Next, coming to therapeutic effect, that is in which condition we can use this Ikshvaku, that is in case of Kasa, Shwasa, Visha, Chardi, Jwara, Kapha Karshitaha. Then Pratamyati, that which that is Pratamaka Shwasa, in that case also, like Shwasa, in that case we can use Kasa, Shwasa, Visha, Chardi, Jwara, Kapha Karshita and Tamaka. In all these cases we can use the Ikshvaku for Vamana purpose. Next is the preparation method in detail form. Payasya Ashtau, that is 8 preparations of Kshira, that is Mushti Parimana, like 1 Mushti Parimana of Pushpa should be taken of this Ikshvaku, and 1 Prastha of Shira should be added and processed. Okay, and it can be administered in the Kafpitta Kafaja Jwara. And further 4 preparation, it is similar to the Jimutaka. Like you can recall Jimutaka, like with the flower, with the fruit, with the ripened one, with the unripened one, like that 4 different Kshira preparation. Then 6th preparation is like Ikshvaku Phalaswarasa, like 3 parts should be added and 4 parts of water should be added, and Kshira should be processed, and this Kshira should be used in Urasthita Kafaha, okay, and Swara Beda and Pinasa. In these condition you can select the Ikshvaku Kshira. Next one is 7th preparation, and here 8th one, like Ikshvaku Bija given Bhavana with the Ajakshira and administered in Visha, Gulma, Udara, Granthi and the Galaganda Shlipada. In all these cases you can use this ikshvaku bija like ajakshira bhavita ikshvaku bija. Next suramanda mastu and takra prayoga, here three preparation. Ikshvaku soaked in suramanda, and that can be used for vamanartha. Then phalan madhyaha, that is middle part of the fruit should be taken, and along with the mastu, like mixed with the mastu, and that can be administered for vamanartha in case of pandu, kushta and visha. Then phalan madhya along with the takra, that is middle part of the fruit should be taken along with the takra, and mixed with the kshaudra and the lavana, and that can be administered. And the common word, the kshaudra and lavana, it is going to give benefit in mainly in the vamana, wherever kapha is involved more. Next is graha yoga. Graha yoga, as to remember, like over the flower we have to sprinkle the powder, and that should be given to the for inhaling purpose. Here the powder of phala and dry flower and fruit should be taken and made it into powder form, and that should be sprinkled over the flower, and that can be given for the vamana purpose. Okay, next is palala. Palala, here the ikshvaku phala should be taken along with the guda or the palala. Next one is taila, that is ikshvaku phala kalka sadita taila can be given for the vamana purpose. Next is vardhamana phala. There are six yoga, you need to remember this one. Very important for exam purpose, those who are appearing for exam. Here, as you know, vardhamana is nothing but just gradually you need to increase the dose. Okay, the drugs, the quantity, what it is there, that gradually you're supposed to increase. Okay, here 50 you have to start. Okay, 50, then further it need to be increased 10 in each day, and when it reaches to 100 you have to stop. Like you have to administer in a vardhamana way, in a increasing manner, and it should be administered along with the kashaya. And wherever that kashaya word is there, you're supposed to understand that is previously how kashaya is prepared, in the same way you have to use the, you have to prepare and use the kashaya. And the drugs here, what it is mentioned, no, madana phala jimutaka ikshvaku damargava kutaja kruta vedana, these six drugs as given in the kalpasthana, these drugs can be used for the kashaya preparation. Next is grita yoga, like previously how it is given, ikshvaku phala processed with kshira, and then you have to made it into dadi, then you have to made it into navanita and prepare grita, then that grita can be used for the vamanartha. Next is kashaya. There are nine in number. Antarnaka mushti of ikshvaku bija should be taken and given along with these nine kashaya yoga. Yashtimadhu kashaya, kovidara kashaya, karbodara, nipa, vidula, bimbi, shana pushpi, sadha pushpi, pratyak pushpi kashaya. Among these, anyone you can select, okay, for the administration. Next is varti prayoga. Once again, there are 8 in number. According to which drug you are using, the naming has been given, like kovidara, karbudara, nipa, vidula, bimbi, shana pushpi, sada pushpi, pratyak pushpi. By using these drug, okay, that what the varti preparation you had done, that can be given along with these kashaya. Next is leha yoga, are 5 in number. Here the drug which you are using, on the base of that, here yoga naming has been given, the number has been given. So here 8 anjali of 8 anjali pramana of bilva mula kashaya or tumbi bija, and you have to process that one and to prepare the leha, and that leha is beneficial for vamanartha. Next, a similar way, here bilva mula kashaya you had used, here agnimanta mula kashaya, shonaka mula or patala mula or gambari mula. Okay, that is bilva panchamula, what it is given, no, bilvadi panchamula, lagu panchamula, Bilwa, Agnimanta, Shonaka, Patala, Gambari. In among all these, any dravya you can use for the preparation. All the five, that is five Leha Yoga. Next is Mantra preparation. Here Mantra Yoga, that is Shaktu is given Bhavana with Tumbi Swarasa and beneficial in Kafajajwara, Kasa, Kantaroga and Arochaka. And Rasa Yoga, Rasa, as you know, that is Mamsa Rasa, that need to be administered in case of Gulma, Prameha and Prasika. Here, wherever the indications are mentioned, that is like you can select such type of drug in that condition. That's it. Okay, that is the indication. Next is Damargava Kalpa. Next chapter is Damargava Kalpa. Here, you can see the see in the photo, that is Damargava. And here is the seeds, useful part, that is seeds. The useful parts are phala, bija and the pushpa. You can see in the photo. Damargava Kalpa. Next is, the synonyms are Karkotaki, Kotafala, Mahajalini, Raja Koshataki. Karkotaki, Kotafala, Mahajalini, Raja Koshataki. These four are the synonyms. Indications are Gara, that is in Visha condition, you can give the Damargava, you can select the Damargava for Vamanartha. Gulma, Udara, Kasa, then Shleshma, Shleshma Shayastita, Vata, that is here, Shleshma Shayastita Vata, here it is mentioned. Because Vatasthana, as you know, below navel region, and if Vata, if it is moved towards the Shleshmashaya, that is above, that is Ura Pradesha, that in that case you can go with the Damargava. Kanta Vaktraste, that is if Swara Beda is there, and also if Kapha, if it is present in the Kanta Pradesha, then you can go with the Damargava. Then Kapha Sanchaya Roga or any sorts of Kapha Vikara, you can treat with the Damargava. Next is here, total 60 yogas are there. That is Kashaya Yoga, once again 9, Kshira Yoga 4, Sura Yoga 1, Kashaya 20, then Kalka Yoga 1, then juice of cow dung, that is Shakrudrasena, that is 12 yoga, and as a ahara 1 along with the ahara, as a Greya Yoga 1, as Leha Yoga 10, and Grita Yoga 1. Next is, that is Pallave Navaha, that is Pallava is the tender leaf of the plant, okay, that should be used for the preparation here. Pallava Raswara Pravala Swarasa, that is Pravala, once again the tip of the the tender leaf, what that will be there, no? That should be taken and made it into dried and made it into gulika form, the tablet form, and that should be administered along with all these kashaya, Eshtimadu, Kovidara, Karbudara, Nipa, Vidula, Bimbi, Shanapushpi, Sadapushpi and Pratyapushpi, like that Pallava. That made it into vati form, and that should be administered in these kashaya. And Kshira Yoga, there are four in number, Pushpa, Payo, Yoga, Chatvaraha, that is as it is given in the Jimutaka Kalpa, same method should be followed here. And Ekaha Surasava Sura, that is one Sura preparation, that is also as similar with the Jimutaka. That is nothing but the drug should be soaked in the sura and keep it aside. And after it get that property, then you can administer for the purpose of Vamanartha. Next is Kashaya. There are 20 in number. As you had studied previously, you are also along with which drug you are using. Okay. That has been named for that. Here, Damargava, Kovidara, Karbudara as given. Jatya, Saumanasya, then Rajanya, Choraka, Rushchira, Mahasaha, Then Shudra Saha, Haimavata, Bimbi, Punanava, Kasamata. These all are the 20 drugs. Kashaya need to be prepared. And along with this, that what you have prepared, Damargava, that can be administered. And Kalka Yoga, that Damargava Salka should be prepared. And along with the Kashaya, you can administer. Or else the Yusha can be prepared and that also can be used. Next is Shakrudrasa. Here, Shakrudrasa, even in Siddhisthana, in many contexts, the usage of Shakrudrasa is mentioned. That is, in many contexts like Gorasa, what it is mentioned, no? That is Shakrudrasa. Go, that is Gomaya Rasa, that chakras should be mixed with the water. Keep it aside for the sediment. That supernatant water should be used for the preparation. Okay, that is actually the chakra drasa. Here, like that, there are 10 different preparation. Like how, which type of that chakra you are using, according to that, the naming has been given. Here, go chakra, ashwa chakra, like different chakra has been given here. Like that, there are 10 Shakratrasa. Then Anna Yoga, that is one yoga. Damargava, along with the Anna, you can administer. Like Yavagu, you had prepared, no? Like in the, as a Purva Karma, Yavagu need to be administered. So here, along with that only, you can mix, then you can administer. Then Greya Yoga 1, that is, as previously mentioned, the Churna should be prepared and sprinkled over the flower. And that flower should be given for the inhalation purpose. And 10 Leha Yoga. Here Jivaka, Rushavaka, Veera, Atmagupta, Shatavari, Kakuli, Shravani, Medha, Mahamedha, Madhulika. These all drugs should be used. Separately it should be used and prepare the Leha. And like this, there are 10 Leha Yoga. Next is Grita Yoga. Damargava should be processed with the kshira and made it into dadi and extract the sneha part, and sarpi should be prepared. This is the sarpi yoga. That is about the Damargava kalpa. Next is about the Vatsaka kalpa. Vatsaka kalpa. Here the useful part is bija. Indrayava, one more synonym commonly used for Vatsaka, Indraeva. Here, the synonyms are Vatsaka, Kutaja, Shakro, Vrukshaka, Girimallika. And Vatsaka Bija is having synonyms like Indraeva and Kalingaka. Okay, Vatsaka synonyms are Vatsaka, Kutaja, Shakra, Vrukshaka, Girimallika. And Vatsaka Bija having the synonyms like Indrayava and Kalingaka. Here, there is a types for Vatsaka. Here I had mentioned the difference. You can go through with that. Here, the fruit will be Bruhatphala in Purusha Kutaja. And that is Pum Kutaja and Stri Kutaja is mentioned. In Stri Kutaja, Alpaphala. The size of the fruit will be very small. Okay. Then, the pushpa, the flower, will be white color, and Stri Kutaja, the flower will be slight arunavarna, and leaf will be snigdha patra in Pum Kutaja, and here in Stri Kutaja, not too much snigdhata will be there. Next is Falavrinta, the Falavrinta will be more bigger one, Bruhat Akara, and here in Stri Kutaja, it is Anu. Now, once again, I'll show this pic. You can observe that one. Here you can observe there is a whitish flowers in one pic, and there is somewhat arunavarna in one more pic. And here the seeds, what it is mentioned, no? these are the seeds, Indrayava. And you can see the fruits here. The size of the fruit you can observe. Next, indications are in Rakta Pitta, Kapha, Kaphagna. That is in Kapha Vikara you can use, and even in a tender person, very delicate person, you can use Sukumhareshu, then Hridroga, Jwara, Vataratta, and Visarpa. In all these cases, you can use this drug And there are 18 preparations are given for the Vatsakaphala, Kashaya Yoga 9, Churna Yoga 5, Jala Yoga 3, and Kshira Yoga 1. And here first one is Kashaya Yoga 9. That is in a seasonal way, how that ripening fruit should be selected and seed should be collected. And here Antarnaka Mushti, that is one that is one fist that should be taken, Antarnaka Mushti, that should be taken. And Jarjari Krutya, completely you have to make it into pounded and add these below said Kashaya and keep it overnight and used along with the Lavana as well as with the honey, Kshaudra. Okay, the Kashaya is like Yashtimadu, Kovidara, Karbudara, Nipa, Vidula, Bimbi, Shana Pushpi, Sada Pushpi and Pratyak Pushpi. Okay, like this 9 Kashaya Yoga. Next is Churna Yoga. There are 5 in number. Okay, Churna Yoga, 5 in number. Arka Kshira should be taken, 1 Panitalla. And this Vatsaka Bija is mixed along with that and keep it aside as it is. And next, it should be administered along with the Jivaka, Madanaphala, or Jimutaka, or Ikshvaku, or Jivanti. Like this, Churna Yoga. Next is Salila Yoga or Jala Yoga. There are 3 preparation, like along with Sarshapa, Maduka, and Lavana. Next is Krushara Yoga, that is Vatsaka Bija, along with the Krushara, that is 1 yoga. So total, there are 18 yoga. You can see the difference and how it is appearing. Next is Krita Vedana, that is the last chapter of Vamana Yoga, Vamana Kalpa, 6th chapter, Krita Vedana. You can see the plant, how it appears. And in first picture, that fruit and inside that, how it appearing, that I had mentioned. And here, one more picture that is indicating both flowers, fruits, everything. You can observe that. Here, as a synonyms, Shweda, Koshataki, Mrudanga Phala. These all are the synonyms of Krita Vedana. Shweda, Koshataki, Mrudanga Phala. And here as a quality, Atyartha Katu Tikshna Ushnaha. Okay, like previously you had studied, no, Madana Phala, Jimutaka, Ikshvaku, Krita Vedana, Damargava. Nowhere such a mentioning was there. That indicates it is Tikshna Tama. As in Virechana, there is a Sudha. There's one of the drug. Sudha. In the same way, here it is Tikshna Tama Dravya Atyartha Katuhu. Okay, Katurasa Pradhana Dravya it is. Then Tikshnata will be more. Okay, then indications are like Gadish Vishtita, that is like deep seated diseases, Kushta, then Pandu, then Pliha Roga, Shofa, Gulma, and Gara. In all these diseases, we can use the Krita Vedana. Here total 60 kalpas are there, Kshira Yoga 4, Sura Yoga 1, Kashaya Yoga 22, Pichcha Yoga 10, Gruta Yoga 1, Varti Yoga 6, Leha Yoga 8, Mamsa Yoga, Mamsa Rasa Yoga 7, and Ikshu Rasa 1. So total 60 in number. Here Kshira Yoga, first one, Kshira Yoga 4 in number. Krita Vedana, flowers should be taken and along with the Kshira, it should be processed. Like the detail it is given in the one chapter, that is in Jimutaka Kalpa, same thing should be followed here also. That is what that Lomashaha, what that is there, no? That not to be considered because these all fruits are not having that one. So here, remaining all should be followed the same. Okay. So that now that 4 kalpa, what it is given in Jimutaka, same preparation need to be followed here. Then Sura 1 yoga, that is Krita Vedana along with the Sura. Like you have to mix with the Sura and that can be given for the Vamanartha. Kwata Dvavimshati. Dvavimshati is 22. Vimshati is 20. Dvavimshati is 22. So here the preparation, like similar way, like the flower and the that should be taken, made it into dry form and make it into powder form and administer along with following kashaya dravya, kashaya. Eshti madhu, kovidara, karbudara, nipa, vidula, like all those drugs. So all those drugs along with that, other drugs like aragvada, vrikshaka, swadukantaka, pata, fatala, shrungeshtaka, murva, shataparna, naktamala, pichumarda, patola, susavi, guduchi. These all total 22 in number. Next is pitcha preparation, krutavedana churna, along with the shalmali. As you know, shalmali is having synonym as pitcha. Okay, so here along with the shalmali, you can use this drug and other drugs like shalmali, shalmalaka, badaraparni, yelaparni, then upodika, uddhala, then dhanvana, rajadana, upachitra and gopi. Like these all drugs, so total 10 preparation. Then gruta one yoga and vartikriya, there are 6 yoga which are similar as like madanaphala. And next is Leha Yoga, 8 in number. Here the preparation method, it is somewhat specified. 50 fruits of Koshataki should be taken. And along with the here, as you know, Kalka Dravya is needed, Kashaya Dravya is needed, Guda is needed. Okay, that is the main 3 things. Here Koshataki, 50 fruits, and prepare the Kovidara Kashaya and add Shweda Kalka, half of that, then avaleha should be prepared. And that should be processed even like kovidara di kashaya, what it is there, no? In place of kovidara, karbudara, nipa, vidula, bimbi, like that, different drugs need to be used for the preparation of leha. So next is 7 mamsa rasa yoga. Here, along with the mamsa, anupa mamsa should be used for the preparation here. And you have to process along with the madanaphala, jimutaka, ikshvaku, damargava, kutaja. These all kashaya along with mamsarasa and krutavedana churna, equal to the mamsarasa, and prepare. Here mamsarasa, kruta mamsarasa, that means you have to add lavana and whatever it is necessary for the preparation of mamsarasa. Next is faladi pipali, other 6 drugs. Here what it is mentioned, those all can be used for the preparation. Next is ikshvakurasa, like krutavedana churna along with the ikshurasa. That is one more preparation. These all are kalpas in questions which are tentatively we can expect from Kalpasthana first 6th chapter. That is, write the importance of Kalpasthana, detail about Jimutaka Kalpa Adhyaya, Krita Vedana Kalpa, Tilvaka Kalpa, Sudha Kalpa, it is from Virechana part, Madana Phala Kalpa. Next, here, list of questions, you can go through with that. That's the end of 6th chapter. If you are having any doubt or any questions, please I'm ready to. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. If you are having any questions in the Charaka Samhita, not only in the Kalpasthana, in the whole Charaka Samhita, you can ask, ma'am. Madam is going to clear your doubts, and even at the exam point of view or otherwise, when you felt any confusions or controversies, etc., those also you can ask, madam. Madam is ready to answer you. You can unmute yourself and you can ask question. Otherwise, you can post your question in the chat box. Hello, madam. Here is a question for you. What is the use of different kalpas of same medicine?
Can you repeat, madam?
Yes, madam. What is the use of different kalpas of same medicine?
Okay. See, all peoples are not willing to take similar type of medicine. Like some peoples are having aversion to take kashaya, or some are not willing to take vati or swarasa. That is the interest of the individual. Okay, by seeing that one, we can select different formulations. And even sometimes we can reduce the effect of the drugs also. Like some drugs, some persons are having mrudu koshta. In them, internal medicine itself is not indicated. In them, just we can go with the gray yoga. Okay, so in that case, such type of preparations will be helpful. Is it
Thank
clear?
You, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Thank you. I think that was only one doubt, madam.
If anything to repeat or anything is there, you can tell me. I can explain that one also. If you have any doubt, you can.
Namaste, ma'am.
Namaste.
Ma'am, till now we read many kalpanas, ma'am, but all those not not available now formulations, ma'am. So how to tackle those, ma'am?
Your voice is not clear.
Akhila, otherwise please post in the chat box.
Your voice is not clear. Can you please repeat or help?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, the question is, these many kalpas are explained here, but many of them are not available. How to manage in the case of non-availability of the kalpas which were described in the classics?
Actually, the drugs are available. Even Madanapala plants also very minimal, but we are searching and we are getting the drugs. It's not like Muthaka is not there, Kata Vedana is not there, but we made it generalized. Okay, like Vamana means we have to select the Madanapala. Okay, we are not going with the other drugs, but even you may come across with some of the examples. Like I'll tell you, like at home, like Vacha we are using. Okay, for children and all, we are using the Vacha. Of course, that is also doing the dosha uklesha, and it is eliminating out the whatever the collected kapha is there. Okay, like according to the availability and according to the purpose, we have to select the drug. It is not like Vamana means it is not Madanaphala. There are drugs are available, and we have to select, we have to identify, we need to process that one, and then we can use that one. And sometimes it is limited to the research as such. Okay, just for research purpose we are taking, and in our clinical practice we are not much successful in that. Okay, in the practice wise. Otherwise, the drugs are available. We have to collect and we make it use.
Thank you, madam. One more question, madam. Is there any difference in treatment aspect according to the formulation?
Yes, because some drugs are having particular qualities, like some are teekshna, some are mrudu, some are having particular rasa. According to that, sure, it is going to cause a different effect. Like in one drug I had told, it is teekshna tama dravya. Katu pradana dravya. The same drug will not be having same effect as like the madanaphala or as like the jimutaka. Of course, it is having the difference in the action.
Thank you, ma'am.
That's why the indications also mentioned, like the pranava, srotu, vikara, in that case, we can use the jimutaka and kritavedana. The effect will be more. But the same indication is not given in other disease. Of course, madanaphala is sarva roga, like that it is mentioned. But in that also, certain limitations are there. Always, supremacy is it's there for certain drugs at, itself. Like in Siddhisthana, what I had mentioned, no? Like for Kushta, Jimutaka is best. In that condition, that drug can be used like that. Okay. Of course, there is a difference.
I hope all the doubts of the viewers got clear. Thank you very much, ma'am. It is very informative, and the concepts and as well as the topics of the chapters also presented very neatly, which included other useful topics like other useful even the things like synonyms and the cross references, how to apply this one. This is very good, ma'am, because so many of us, we don't know that part, which you taken the cross reference from the jirne adike or jirna ante during the jirna bhojana jirna, what are the drugs and how we should color. It was very informative, ma'am, and even for the students also, you presented very in a good manner. Ma'am, here one more question, it is there.
Yeah.
Okay, one second. Can these formulations we apply for pediatric practice? Can we apply these formulations for pediatric practice?
No.
Panchakarma anarha.
Panchakarma. No. Actually, in 30th chapter, it is mentioned, 30th chapter of Chikitsa Sthana, it is mentioned that whatever the medicines given in the Charaka Samhita, it is for Madhyama Vaya, Madhyama Bala, for all Madhyama, what it is there, no, for them it is mentioned. According to the age, we have to reduce the dosage, and wherever it is necessary, we can increase the dosage. That reference we are getting. But as directly it is mentioned, vamana is not indicated in pediatric case. That's why I said, while telling the synonyms of vamana, that ullekana, kapha ullekana is indicated, not the vamana is indicated as such. Okay, like whatever the collected kapha is there, that should be eliminated out, not the whatever the shastra of the vamana is given, not to be. And wherever the Sukumara, in Sukumara, we can administer like this mentioned, no? That you can try. That's it.
Thank you, ma'am. Ma'am, is whether Purva Karmas are necessary for the Vasti or not? Here one more question it is there.
Can you repeat, madam?
Purva Karmas, Sneha Sveda Karmas are advisor for Vasti also. Or not?
Yes, it is advised. Like snehana, svedana, what it is given, no? Even snehana, we have to consider this abhyanga. That is also snehana. Okay, not the what that arohana krama, that snehana is there, no? That is not followed. But snehana and svedana is necessary. Okay, what that sveda we are administering, maybe nadi sveda followed with the abhyanga, that we have to consider as a snehana and svedana. Even for niruha basti, even for anumasana basti, we are following the same. Okay, that itself is snehana and svedana. Maybe the range what it is and the way what we are giving, that may be differed, but snehana and svedana is necessary. And even after the basti karma, what sansajana krama is there, that not to be followed. Rasadi krama need to be followed. This is very clearly mentioned, Siddhisthana first chapter. If possible, please go through with that.
Thank you, madam. On behalf of Department H4D, Dr. K.M. Bhatt, sir, Dr. Khalid, sir, staff of SJGMC, principal and the management, myself, Dr. Hema, I'm very much thankful to you, ma'am, for accepting our invitation and delivering such a beautiful and very informative and useful session, ma'am. I'm very much thankful to you from my bottom of my heart.
Thank you, madam.
And I'm very much thankful to you, all the viewers who participated in the session and who are viewing in the YouTube also. These recordings will be available. Even tomorrow's session also will be available in the YouTube. Thank you. Thank you, one and all. Thank you once again, ma'am.
Thank you, madam.
There tomorrow is one more announcement. Very soon we are going to upload the sessions, session of 11 to 20 chapters very soon. Sorry for the delay in that. And for tomorrow, please stay tuned for tomorrow's session from chapter 7 to 12. You can even interact with them, madam. If you are having any doubts, even some of the PG scholars from other states also are viewing here. You can also clear your doubts, as madam is even postgraduate teacher for the postgraduate scholars also. Okay. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you.
Madam, one more question here it is there.
Yes.
Can you please tell the difference between samsarjana krama and rasa samsarjana krama?
Okay. Samsarjana krama, that is peya, vilepi, krita, akrita, mamsarasa, what it is there, no? That one. But rasadi krama, there usually basti we are administering in case of vata vikara. Okay. Wherever vata is mainly involved, in that case, we are using the basti. So, wherever vata is increased, we have to give this sneha dravya. Okay. And mamsa is considered as a shreshta sneha dravya. Like easily the snehanta can be increased and even vata can be subsided by the such type of rasa. So which is lagu and which gives more nourishment. Even sadhya santarpana dravya, among that mamsa rasa is mentioned, such type of dravya should be given. Easy for digestion, and which increases the digestive power and as well as which nourishes the body. Such type of dravya need to be followed. That is rasadi krama. Is it clear?
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
If any more doubts, ma'am will stay for 2 minutes. You can ask now also. One more dot here, ma'am. What should be done if the patient is a vegetarian?
Then use other preparations. Okay. In Ashtangradaya, there are sadhya santarpana dravyas are mentioned. There are 7 different sadhya santarpana dravyas are mentioned. You can use any of them. Okay. The criteria is it should be easily digestible. It should increase the digestive power. Okay. Third one is which should nourish the dhatu. Okay. Only that three criteria it should fulfill. Okay. The intention of sansajana krama itself is the increasing of or enhancement of the digestive power. That too in the gradual manner we have to increase. Especially in basti, mamsarasa is given because already the person is in the shoshana avastha. Vata is increased and after the shodhana, once again you are increasing the dosha. Okay. So in that case, we have to give mamsarasa or which will enhances the dhatu. Such type of dravyas are selected.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much for all the viewers. And once again, thank you very much, ma'am. Tomorrow, please stay tuned at 1 p.m. Madam is going to deliver 7th chapter of Kalpasthana to 12th chapter of Kalpasthana. Thank you, one and all. Have a nice day.
Thank you so much.